Welcome to the Creed, and today we are talking and working on neural networks and Unity. We want to teach a car to drive this track with machine learning. New Unity have built-in system called ML Agents, but we're not using this system. We use custom third-party library for neural networks and supervised learning. Not genetic algorithms, but supervising. If you are not familiar with neural networks, you should find some other tutorials, basic like XOR examples or character recognitions, but not this. Neuron.net core library is just DLL that you can download and place into your project here. Of course, you all know about AForge if you worked before with neural networks, but we can't make it work properly with Unity. It just gives a big learning error, sometimes, not often, but sometimes, but not suitable for teaching this car. So first approach was use arrays for sampling the world data around our car, and we cast about 8 arrays around our hero to see where obstacles is, like this. And we just now driving the car. The system is scanning data, my input. I am playing the game and trying to store all the data. Neuron.net is not very optimized library, not using all the cores for teaching. I mean, modern libraries can use even GPU for really speed up teaching of the neural networks, but this library is very old and not using it. If you have some really simple like array of doubles input and the output library and works fast with C#, you should say something in the comment. We can also add it as backend for our neural network teaching system. Why not using genetic algorithms? Because teaching of them can takes really a lot of time. Sometimes it's more interesting to see how they're teaching, how they're evolving. But in real games, I think it's more useful to you teach on the player input as agent's behavior. So you can see that we finished hitting space, and now we have this value detected, I mean wrong data. The system just remove wrong data, I mean if the same input, we should remove with the same input other outputs. We removed based on the popularity of some data. I mean if we just having some obstacle and sometimes move right, and just two times move left, more often right and was stay, and moving left just remove from the input set. So that's it. Let's teach our neural network hitting T button. And you can see the arrows changing. The main thread of the Unity not blocking. You can check and click on the error value. That's very suitable. It was not obvious with this library not blocking the main thread, and very useful because you see the progress of the learning, and you can stop it in some ways. If you find a local minimum or find a local maximum, you can just hit run to teach very very fast. Let's wait for something better than 6% of error. Okay, it's moving faster. Now we have 10, so we now have less. Of course, the teaching process depends because firstly, all the weights of the neural networks assign randomly, so every time it could be random, and teaching as because it's a random process, in fact. Let's wait a while. Now it's become more and more. Sometimes it's learned about on 500 iteration, but sometimes it takes 200 to 2000 iterations to learn. Okay, let's run because it's really small error now. Just click air button on the keyboard like this, and you can see that our car is actually driving, not me driving the car. It's now running neural network and predicts, find the decision what to do. It's not, and now it's stuck. Why it's stuck? Because this data of the raycast is not enough for teaching neural networks. I mean, this small situation, rays are very thin and sampling data is not very actually physically, because we see our world, we're not acting like rays. With rays we can see objects behind the wall, and where is it is very incorrect while teaching your neural network. That's why it sometimes and really often stuck with using rays. I'm now help our hero by just moving position from the editor, and you can see it continue moving. And stuck again. This is a debug data coming to neural networks. You can probably see that it's sampled by 0.2 value, not just linear data. And the output of the neural networks, this left movement and this one is right movement. Okay, now it's stuck again. Let's see our second approach using using sphere cast and some kind of real vision according to nature of seeing things. Like this one, we have a lot of sphere casts sampling our world. I really know that placing the game in 2D area and the matrix will be much easier, but not realistic and not very useful in the real games where shape does matter. So just sampling the world in the real time with sphere cast, it's not very fast, I know it, but it's more and more interesting, so I can implement in every game, every 3D game or every shapes. It will be more common for usage in the game industry. Let's drive our car. Of course, the input vector of the neural networks will be much bigger with such approach. We have really a lot of input data, and that's why teaching process will be really slower, because and the data input will be much bigger and the input vector bigger. That's why teaching is not very fast. Almost finished here. Let's hit space to stop it and wait much longer to removing unnecessary wrong data. As you can see, we have really bigger data as input. That's why teaching process will be slower but more efficient. Let's teach. You can see it's laggy now. Draw gizmos with sphere cast calls batches. That's why I have such a lot of batches here. Of course, you can find some very fast neuron.network library for C sharp. It will be very good. Oh, now we have quite small error. I think we could run our neural network. As you can see, it's that teached really faster than rays because data was more correct. That's why it's not just remember it, but interpolate, approximate. Oh, now it's really stuck again. Let's try to help it much more. As you can see, here is the input data of the sampled world with obstacles and the normalized position of our hero according to the wall track, and the output data for moving left or right. As you can see, the movement of the hero is much more interesting because he analyzing the real world, analyzing next steps, but stuck anyway. I think we should add some stuck parameter to avoid stucking, and that's why he could really finish the game with no such problem. Okay, let's stop. It was our second approach. Let's see the code to see how it's organized and how we can use it in your projects, because we did it for you, not starting from scratch. If you want to investigate or research in neural networks and Unity in this supervised learning, not genetic algorithms. We have more created structure called train records. We have input and the output as a double array constructor and override equals to compare data for future data processing. Let's go to hero. Here we can state machine with enums, our neural network. As watch, we have input moving left or right. Also add velocity, calculate points for rake, calculate every point here when we called run here. It was all procedurally, so you can just tweak, add more points or less points for make your data more precision or not. And here training set, this methods for creating train forming set. We send in ray cost and just set z1 if we have obstacle in such point and 0 if we have no obstacle. Also we add our position according to a track normalized style and form a new train record, and then just add our example of train record to the train set. Of course, if it's already contains in train set, we just increase in index of usage amount at, like here. On draw gizmos, drawing all the input data so you can analyze it. After we are finished running, we can hit teach. Here's a teaching state you can find here. We can also just turn this like this. In teaching state, we are increasing iterations, teach at one iteration our network, and forming error for debugging it directly in Unity. When we click run, we start in our neural network, calculate points, and got the results as the output vector here, the res. According to res vector, we just moving right or left our hero. That's it. We all place just in one script. If you for bit more simplified, and we can you can start from this. Of course, you need a train record to work with it. So I think it will be useful for you if you are interested in neural network and machine learning things with Unity. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, download. Bye.